Hey guys, hope you're doing fine. This is Ankit Bhatia and welcome back to my channel. Now it's been long time that I've recorded my video in studio, but this is my new studio. You can see this side, it's all of my, you know, shelf and everything, all my camera equipments. And this side, it's stable and I just have to order one light here so that it will come on my face and, you know, look good. But otherwise it's almost ready, and today we're going to talk about this one thing that a lot of people have been asking me about, like which mic do you use, how you create your voiceover, how do you edit. So this will be just one video. We'll be telling you everything from start to end, like how I started and which mic I used in the starting, and then what is my setup right now and how do I edit my audio, my voiceovers, what do I do. So everything, so just stick to the end of the video and you will know by the end of the video, I mean. Okay, so when I first started making videos, this is the mic that I used. It's from Rode. It's a lavalier mic and you can connect it with the phone and you can plug it in here and then you can start making videos. But the only thing is you have to sync it up later, so it's not that good for traveling. Let's say you're traveling and you're on a 10-day tour and you're recording every day and you're using this mic and connect the phone and you've got all the audio and the video, but you have to sync it up later in the Premiere Pro and it's going to be a big task. Trust me, it's a very big task and sometimes like it's very painful. So I knew that like I have to get a new mic for traveling or for my recordings. So at that time I used to make tutorials and mostly I used to do voiceover because, you know, I didn't have the confidence to speak on the camera, so I didn't make much vlog at that time. So I needed a mic for my studio mostly and like for voiceover, and I searched and I found like this Scarlett Studio Pack, and this is the mic I started using. But the only problem is like it's very heavy and you cannot use it with the camera. You have to record your audio with the laptop. But at that time it was fine because I was just making tutorials, and soon I realized that, you know, my laptop used to hang sometime. Let's say you're doing the screen recording, I'm doing the Premiere Pro effect showing and making video, and at the same time I'm recording my audio with the laptop, and you know, my laptop used to just hang with all this setup, and I knew that like, oh, this is not going to work in long term. But I just keep making the videos with that mic only, and after some time somehow I got confident and I started making vlogs. For that I knew that this Scarlett Studio and this lavalier mic it's just not going to work. I have to get a new mic. So this is the mic from the Rode. It's a Video Mic Pro Plus and it's really good for traveling. I have recorded all of my vlogs with this mic and it's really good, I can say that. But when you record the audio in studio like this, it's not that good. I mean, it's good, but it's not that good. I was just saying that I needed a different mic for my studio, and at the same time I was just so lucky Comica Audio reached out to me and they have sent out the exact products I needed. So this is one of the product. This is a wireless mic and it is best for interviews because this has two transmitter, one receiver, and it connects directly with the camera because this guy right here, it does the job. So I don't need to record with the phone and I'll still get a good audio, good quality audio. But right now I'm not using this setup. I'm using Okay, I'm using this setup. So this is the second product they've sent out to me. It's a shotgun mic and this is my setup right now. You won't see in this camera, but that camera, get that guy right there, it's recording. So just show us the video. So this is the shotgun mic and I'm using the same receiver from this product. This is the receiver that connects with the both of the mic. The good thing is you can connect wirelessly or you can connect wired as well. So for wireless connection you need this transmitter, and they sent out this product as well. So I've connected this transmitter right here and the receiver right there, and this is the audio that you are getting. And I'll show you some test as well. Now I'm so happy that this is wireless and I can just sit anywhere and just set it up and good to go. And I now can just record my tutorials with good audio without worrying about it's gonna hang or not. So now I'm going to show you a few tests from both of these mics and you see that. And after that I'll show you how I edit my audio, how I edit my voiceover. I'll show you all the process. Wait for that. So right now I've connected my camera with this lavalier mic instead of this shotgun mic because I just want to show you the difference, the audio quality that you'll get from both these mics. The good thing with this mic is you can move around anywhere in the room or anywhere within 100 meters and you'll still get the good quality. I'm standing right there. Let's say if I'm speaking this side or any side, you will still get the best quality because this transmitter is right here. And with this shotgun mic, the limitation is that you just have to sit and talk. So this is mostly I'll use if I'm moving around, and this mic, shotgun mic, I'll use if I'm just sitting and talking. And for the voiceover also, I use this shotgun mic. So now you're seeing the audio quality from both these mics, and I'll show you now how I record my voiceover, and then the final step would be how to edit it. So let's go, and for that I'll connect my shotgun mic again. So for voiceover, I'll set up a mic like this. I'll be sitting very close and I'll use this foam. This is also from Comica Audio. With this foam, I'll get even better quality of audio. And once that is done, and when I start recording, I'll take a pause for the first 5 seconds. Like I'll not be saying anything, so it'll capture all the background noise. And later on, I'll tell the software that this is the background noise removed from the whole audio. And it's so easy to do that. So always do this before start recording, before start doing the voiceover. And for editing, I use two softwares. One is Audacity and one is Premiere Pro as a final step. So once my recording is done, I'll open up the audio in Audacity. And the first thing that I'll do is I'll convert my audio into mono if it's not already converted. And then I'll remove noise reduction. I'll select the first 5 seconds, and then I'll go to the noise reduction and get noise, and then again I'll go to the noise reduction. This is a setting that I will be using, and I'll just click OK. You can use the same. Now once that is done, I guess the noise is just removed from the whole audio. And the next step that I'll do is I'll go to the compressor, and this is the setting that I use for all of my audio, so you can use the same, and then hit OK. Now your audio will be more crisp. And the next step that is really important, what I do is I have this plugin I downloaded for Audacity. This is iZorp Nectar 2. I'll go to this plugin and I'll just select this effect, male commercial. This is the effect that I like the most, and it just does the magic. Just hit OK and just go through the whole audio, and it just make it more crisp, clear, amazing. So the next step that I'll do now is to go and amplify the audio. I'll go to the amplify and just hit OK. It'll just give the automatic number, so you don't need to change it anything. Now after all these steps, I'll just export the audio from Audacity, and then I'll go to the Premiere Pro and just import the audio there. Now in Premiere Pro, I have already created my preset, which took me some time, but I have fine-tuned it, and it makes my audio more crisp, clear. It's just amazing. So I'll go to the effects panel and just drag it onto my audio, and it's done. It's just like that, done. Now you'll listen to the audio, it'll be amazing. So what I'll do is I'll attach this preset, and the link is in the description. You can download for free for the first week, and you can try it on your audio, and you can see that like how beautiful it is. So that's what I do with my audio, with my voiceover. That's how I edit. These are the steps that I always use. So try it out and let me know in the comments below, how do you like it? With that said, guys, I'm also doing one Q&A video, because it's been a while, we have not done any Q&A. So please ask me questions in the comments below, and I'll go through it and I'll make one video on that. So that's it for the video. Hit like, subscribe and share, and I'll see you in my next video. Till then, take care. Bye bye. Okay, it didn't happen like that. Finally, it's done. Now you know everything from start to end. If anybody asks you how to make your voiceover better, just give them this video. They will know. Yeah, I mean, why are you talking? It's the video is done. I don't know. Let's just. Okay. Bye.